Welcome to the Paleobotanical Collections out on West Campus. My name's Rudy Serbet. I'm a paleobotanist, and a paleobotanist is a person that studies fossil plants. I'm also the collections manager for the Division of Paleobotany. What does the collection manager do? My job is to look after the collection so that it can be used for research, for teaching, and also be able to have the collection available for future scientists. I have been a collection manager now for about 23 years. Within the paleobotanical collection, we have tens of thousands of specimens. These specimens come from all places on Earth and also from almost all geologic time. Some of our oldest specimens are around 1 to 2 billion years old, and some of the youngest specimens we have are from after the last glaciation, which are roughly about 10 to maybe 20,000 years old. Majority of our collection is from Antarctica. These specimens range in age from the Permian up into the Jurassic. We've collected from a number of sites in Antarctica, and from each of these sites, we've collected a variety of different types of leaves, like these Dicroidium, which are Triassic in age. We have a large selection of Permian fossils, and one of the most famous ones is the Glossopteris. The Glossopteris leaves actually help solidify the theory of continental drift. When the Glossopteris was found on India, Antarctica, Australia, South America, that suggested that at one time these continents were a major continent, Gondwana. This really solidified that theory because, as you know, plants can't just get up and walk around. So one of the things that I'm also involved with is to be able to catalog the specimens so they're all numbered, so that all the locality information, who collected the material, what age it is, what formation it occurred in. So all of that is available with each of the specimens. And after all this is done, then all that information is entered into our specified database. And then subsequently that is put online and is available to scientists around the world. These particular specimens come from a place in Kansas, which is called the Hamilton Quarry, which is east of the city or town of Emporia. And these particular ones are a little over 300 million years old. A recent project in Lawrence revealed a beautiful deposit of Pennsylvanian plant material, which is about 300 million years old. The construction was to install tunnels under Iowa Street. The project went on for approximately a year, and during this time, we were able to collect thousands and thousands of plants from this deposit, and these are a few of the plants that we have collected. Most of these fronds or leaves belong to a group called the seed ferns. What's interesting about this group is the leaves look like they're fern leaves, but they reproduce by seeds. Ferns, on the other hand, which we see in this drawer here, look very much like the seed ferns, but however, they are true ferns and they reproduce by spores. These have yet to be cataloged or identified, and so there's a very big project here to tend to. Preparation of these specimens, when we look at the detail on the inside, it can be exquisite. And the technique that we use in order to get the information out of this type of preservation is what's known as the peel technique. In the video, you can see one of my colleagues demonstrating this technique. And you can see the cellular detail is very pronounced. I hope you've enjoyed your virtual tour of the Paleobotanical Collection here at KU. The collection is very vast, and I just try to touch on a few things within the collection. So hopefully you'll be able to take away a little bit of information the next time you're out collecting fossils. Some pointers for that, always make sure that you have permission where you're collecting and to make sure that you're doing it legally. One of the most important things also is to make sure that you write down where you had found the fossil. You can contact the museum if you have any questions or comments, or if you need help in IDing one of the fossils that you have found. I'd like to thank everybody for joining me. And with that, I'd like to say happy National Fossil Day. Enjoy.